if there is another strategy which Satan is using to the people of God, is that one of hardening your heart.
Uma ngabe-ke kuthiwa khona indlela usathane ayisebenzisayo yile yokuthi enze abantwana bakaNkulunkulu baqinise iy'nhliziyo zabo.
And it's a pity or a shame that many of the Christians, you are very much unaware of this strategy that Satan uses against your Christian life.
Kungamahloni-ke futhi kuyaswabisa ukuthi abaningi bethu amakholwa asiyazi leyo ndlela usathane ayisebenzisa ukuqinisa iy'nhliziyo zethu.
Satan, he will always harden your heart so that you will no longer hear the voice of God.
Usathane uzoyenza ukuthi iqine inhliziyo yakho ungasalizwa izwi likaNkulunkulu.
He will harden your heart so that you will no longer obey the word of God.
Uzoqinisa inhliziyo yakho ukuthi ungasaphinde uhloniphe izwi likaNkulunkulu.
And this is the trap that many of us children in the church of God, we are falling into.
Lokhu-ke kungumgibe thina abantwana bakaNkulunkulu esithola sizwele phakathi kwawo.
And this trap is the trap which Satan has been using for many years. Even now, 21st century, he is still using the same trap unto us.
Lowe kugibe usathana lisebenzisile iminyaka neminyaka nanamhlanje usalisebenzisa. Isimo senhliziyo yakho makhelwane.
Ask the other neighbor, how is the condition of your heart?
Ubuzo omunye umakhelwane ukuthi njani senhliziyo.
And tell me, what is your neighbor saying?
Utshela umfundisi ukuthi uthini umakhelwane.
Yes, it is true, the hearts of your neighbor, it has been hardened by the devil.
Kuyiqiniso inhliziyo kamakhelwane yenziwe lukhulu uSathane.
When we pray our own will and no longer the will of God.
Nanoma sithandaza sithandaza ngentando yethu hayi ngekaNkulunkulu.
Where we go, we are led by our own desires and wills and no longer by the Spirit of God.
Nalasiya khona sihamba ngokwentando yethu nangokufuna kwethu hayi ngekaNkulunkulu.
When we pray, we say only our will be done and not your will, God, be done.
Noma sikhuleka sithi kwenzeke yethu kuphela intando hayi kaNkulunkulu.
People, you must be aware of this strategy Satan is using.
Sifanele ukuthi siqaphelisise le ndlela uSathane ayisebenzisayo.
And the moment you fell into the trap of Satan,
mawuwela nje kulolu gibe lika Sathane,
you started to move away from God.
Uyaqhela kuNkulunkulu.
You drift apart with God.
Uyahlukana noNkulunkulu.
And you do never tell me that you never see this one coming.
Ungeke ukutshela.
Step by step, you are no longer reading the word of God.
Uloku thathunyawo thathunyawo usalifundisa kaNkulunkulu.
Step by step, you no longer pray to God.
Unyawo nonyawo usakhuleka kuNkulunkulu.
Step by step, you are no longer in fellowship with the Spirit of God.
Unyawo nonyawo awusahlanganeli noNkulunkulu labantu
bakaNkulunkulu. Step by step, you no longer attend church services.
Kancane kancane usalake.
Step by step, you don't give, you don't tithe in the house of God.
Kancane kancane unikela ukhipha koshume
endlini kaNkulunkulu. And when we see a person like you,
masibona umuntu njengawe.
We know that Satan has hardened your heart.
Siyazi ukuthi uSathane uyenze lukhulu.
Church, when we harden our hearts towards the will of God, we are destined to perish in hell. When we harden our hearts against God, that fellowship, it gets broken. Paul here, he gave an example of the Israelites in the wilderness journey to the promised land. He told us about the conditions of the heart of the Israelites in the wilderness. Even though God saved them from the hands of the Egyptians, they remain rebellious to the word of God. Even they saw God dividing the Red Sea, they remain rebellious towards the word of God. They always complain and murmured. They always talk bad about God. They always talk bad about the servant of God. And they also refuse to receive the promised land. Even though they receive the promise from God, a covenant promise, they refuse to enter that rest. And as such, look what happened to the Israelites in the wilderness. They wandered the wilderness for 40 years. And all of them who left Egypt, they never entered the promised land. Why? Because they were a rebellious people. People whose hearts they were hardened. Hardened to an extent that they even formed their own idol, they proclaimed it to be God. Hardened in such a way that they also burn incense. Hardened in such a way that they even tried to stone the servant of God. And when we look at the present day church, we see the Israelites behavior. Our hearts have been hardened by the devil. And as such, we are failing to receive the promise of God. God has promised so many things unto us in His word. It is a covenant which God made with us. He has promised so many blessings unto us. He has also promised us to take us to a land of rest. But church, we are going to our own direction. We are no longer walking the ways of God. And as such, we are failing to come closer to our blessings. We are failing to receive what God has promised us. Why? Because of our hearts. Satan has hardened our hearts, Christians. Look at yourself. Introspect yourself. I'm not talking about when you are seated here. I'm talking about outside the church service. After church service until Saturday, 12 o'clock midnight. How is the condition of your heart? What is it that is in your mind? Church, Satan has taken control of our lives. We are failing to be what we are supposed to be because our hearts, they've been hardened by Satan.